Hey, good people. So this is the last guitar in the new Sigma series. I showed you a video a couple weeks ago on the new Folk and Triple O models. This is the Dreadnought, and this is one of the new Sigma reboot models. I think it's exclusive to Amazon, I'm not sure. It's the 10D, and it is a solid top. Mahogany back and sides, all the same specs as the other two, but slightly lighter. It's not as it doesn't have that sort of antique lacquer looking finish. It's a lighter, blonder finish. Very handsome, all very traditional specs with the tortoiseshell pickguard, black binding, satin neck, gloss body, rosewood fretboard and bridge, mother of pearl inlays. There's your headstock, and there's the kicker, Grover's. So this guitar, you can get under 200. The prices fluctuate. I'm selling mine for, I think, about 220, and some guy took umbrage with me on the last video because he went and checked out my sales on Reverb. And I get tired of explaining this, but not only do I do a full 1 to 2 hour setup on this, so I go through and bevel the fret ends that are slightly rough, dress the frets, oil the fretboard, set the action, take care of any other issues if the saddle's too high or too low. Not only do I do all that stuff, but I also couple it with my sales with a nice gig bag. You know, and these aren't free. I buy them in bulk, but they're not free. Yeah, for a gig bag like that, you'd pay $39-$45. So, you know, you gotta bear that in mind. Also, as I pointed out to that fellow, since these became available, the prices keep going, and it seems like they list 20 at a time, and every time they restock, the prices go up $10-$15. I believe the Folk and the Triple O guitar have already, I think, in the last two restocks, gone up about $20-$25, and it looks like these are too. So these are, you can get these, I think, free shipping, just the guitar, factory setup, I think for $149 at the moment, but it keeps going up. So these are good enough to sell for $200. I don't care what anyone says. They are definitely on a par with the Yamaha FG700 and FG800 series guitars because they have that solid Sitka top, really nice mahogany, Sapelli mahogany in the back. And then you've got, I think it actually beats the Yamaha because not only do you have rosewood fretboard and bridge, but you have these Grover tuners on them. So, you know, I think right now I would actually say that if you're going to buy an entry-level acoustic guitar and you only have $200 to spend or $250 to spend, this. That's how much I like these guitars. It's an incredible spec'd guitar for this price, and no one else is coming close. I don't think it's going to last. I think this is an introductory offer, and I think you'll see these right around the $250 mark in the next few months. If they continue to make them, they may just be testing the market with these, but they're good enough. I think they're going to become a full run, but they're not going to stay at these prices, that's for sure. You just can't get these specs for this price, especially with the Grover tuners on them. A lot of people buy cheap guitars and they upgrade to Grover tuners, and if you've ever done that and had to buy a set of Grovers, you know they're not cheap. Also, you know, with the wood selection and the solid top, that makes it a great deal. I just wanted to show you this because I only have one of them, and somebody will grab it with these specs for sure. Anyway, this is the 10D, the new Sigma. It's a reboot campaign for them. They were owned by Martin, and I think they were owned by, I want to say Alvarez, but I'm not sure. And now they're owned by another company, and these are the new models. They do have some high-end stuff. I was on their website looking around. They've got some really nice looking guitars in the 5, 6, $1,000, $1,500 range. So they're not just an entry-level guitar maker. They make all the ranges, and some of the guitars look absolutely stunning. So this is the new Sigma. I showed you the Folk and the Triple O concert auditorium guitar. This is the Dreadnought. This is probably their best seller, the 10D. Really nice specs on this. All right, there you go. See you next time.